Fibers can be used in many applications, including dresses that we are wearing and home textiles. So in that sense, we are covered with fibers from head to toe. Fibers can also be used in some advanced application, like in membrane technology or medical textiles. During the last 5 years, I have worked on some of this application, and this is a very brief overview about the past projects. This is the journey to the amazing world of fibers. I'm sure you are all familiar with surgical masks. These are made of three layers of nonwovens, and they are filtering small particles. And hopefully, they are going to protect us against the spread of viruses. Membranes made of nanofibers are emerging as a better alternative because a thin layer of nanofibers is a much better filter for removing aerosols. Let's take a closer look at nanofibers under the microscope. A human hair with a diameter on average 60 to 70 micrometer is compared with nanofibers here. Nanofibers are more or less 100 times smaller than a human hair. Let me tell you about electrospinning, how we have produced nanofibers. This is the process that we normally make polymer solution, and polymer solution is pumped through a capillary. This capillary is very small, with a diameter of, let's say, 1 millimeter or smaller. And then in front of this capillary, there is a conductive collector. It can be a rotating drum. And high voltage, high DC voltage is applied between this nozzle and collector. As a result, the polymer solution is stretched or ejected towards this collector. During the time of flight, solvent evaporates, and therefore it will turn into hundreds of nanofibers, and they randomly distribute on the surface of the collector. There are many parameters involved here that they affect the fiber diameter, size, and distribution. The voltage that we are applying, the speed of the collector, the size of the nozzle, the polymer concentration, viscosity, temperature, humidity, there are many parameters involved in order to produce a suitable mesh. So all of these should be optimized. You can see nanofibers under microscope under high magnifications. These are randomly distributed on top of each other, and there are some gaps between them. In reality, we cannot see these gaps in these fibers by naked eyes. But these pores, in order to tune these pores and nanofibers, we need to optimize the parameters. Waterproof breathable layers are needed for protecting us against extreme weather, like heavy rain and snow. So the idea for producing a hydrophobic membrane made of these nanofibers is that the pores, if their pores are small, they will not let water to pass through them, but these pores are large enough to let the transport of oxygen and water vapor. To highlight the importance of breathability, just think about this person. If he sleeps in this tent, and tent is not breathable. Porous membrane made of nanofibers can also be used for separation of oil from water. This is an amazing application that can be used, for example, for wastewater treatment, for food production, and also for oil spill cleanup. A mixture of oil and water is pumped through this device, and oil can be separated efficiently. Of course, there are parameters involved here. The pore size distribution is a very important factor for removing and separating oil from water. Nanofibrous membranes can also be used for producing drinking water from salty seawater. The idea is that the seawater at high temperature, let's say 70 to 80 degrees centigrade, is circulated on one side of this membrane. So the heart of this machine actually is the hydrophobic membrane made of nanofibers. And on the other side, as you can see, cold water can be circulated. This membrane will not allow salty water to pass through, but water can evaporate on the surface of a membrane and transport to the other side. It will be condensed, and gradually we can produce more and more drinking water. The energy to the system can be provided by solar radiation. Nanofibers have very high surface area to volume ratio. Therefore, by chemical treatment, we can functionalize them and turn them into superabsorbent with high capacity for removal of pollutants from water. In this example, the pollutant is a textile dye. Fibers have also many applications in medical textiles. I have listed some of them here, and we have worked on two of them, surgical mesh and vascular graft with very small diameter. Surgeons normally, they are inserting a surgical mesh made of synthetic, non-resorbable, non-biodegradable polymer most of the time polypropylene inside the body for hernia repair and reinforcing the abdominal wall. Sometimes these meshes, they come in contact with nerves and it causes some discomfort and pain and sometimes chronic pain, and then surgeons should remove them from the body. So in one of our projects, we produce a resorbable surgical mesh by electrospinning. So after 2-3 months, that they can strengthen the abdominal wall, they will resorb in the body. The concept is very similar to the concept of resorbable sutures. So these are some of the projects that I've already worked on. There are many more, like drug delivery and vascular grafts. So nanofibers can be used for encapsulation of drugs. So there are many other projects that you may think about. And if you are interested, you can contact me. I have a background in textile chemistry and fiber science, as I have recently joined the Department of Bioproducts and Biosystems at Aalto University. There are many companies and research places that they have already developed technologies for producing fibers from forest biomass. In order to work on the whole value chain of these textile fibers, there is a need for the development of environmentally friendly textile coloration and finishing. I'm taking on this new challenge during the coming years. Thank you for watching.